Hey everyone, I'm Bill Griggs from CNC Router Tips, and I'm going to do an unboxing today of a new item that I recently got. This just came in the mail recently, and I wanted to show it to you. It's called an Acorn CNC Controller, and it's from Centroid. Now, I saw this online. I watched a video about it and talked and saw it on the website. And I called up the company and talked to them. And then I ordered one with my own money. So this is not a promotion of theirs, but it is, just a new technology. So I wanted you to see it live right now. Had some nice paper packing in. This is an anti-static bag with the Acorn controller in. We'll open that up in just a moment. It's a packing list. Okay, this is the AC power cord, and it has the spade connectors already crimped on to the end, so you can hook them up to the power supply. And this is another set of wiring. I'm not sure exactly what this is for, but it's probably from the board to the from the power supply to the board. And if you notice, it's got wire ferrules and the spade connectors on it. But you see, these wire ferrules make it really easy to connect up wires. That stuff's in there. There is a 15-foot shielded Cat 5 cable. And this goes between the board and the computer. And this is a power supply, and it's 6/10 of an amp and 120 in and 24 volts, 1.1 amp out. Okay, and you'll need this to power up the board. You've got your different connections that you be able to hook it up to. Let's get a look at the Acorn board itself. I'm gonna Okay, this is the Acorn controller. And what's unique about this controller is that it has a motion control processor built into it. That's a Beaglebone green, I believe. It also has lots of other features on here. So we'll start here. Ethernet in. Here is where you put in your power from that power supply. The 24 volts goes in. Let's see. This one is for wiring up a variable frequency drive. This DB9 connector allows you to plug in a encoder. So if you wanted to monitor the RPMs of a motor or a position of a servo, you could do it with this encoder. There's a DB25 for using a parallel port legacy kind of thing, you know, if you've got an older computer. We've got some other inputs and outputs along here. These let you hook up the various stepper motors or servo motors, depending on what you want. You could use a clear path servo if you wanted to. You could use regular stepper motors or what have you, and just plug them into here. What's really cool is you could use a Gecko G540, or you could use the clear path servos, or you could use a Leadshine board and hook the drivers up to this, and it'll just run it.
You've got things for e-stops, limit switches. There's 8 inputs and 8 outputs. There's 2 relays built in for, you know, in the outputs. The other 6 are, you know, just hook them up through the wiring and off you go. So there's a lot here on this board.
So another cool thing about this so far is online, they've got documents which show you how to hook this thing up.
Like for instance, if you wanted to hook it up to a variable frequency drive, like the Wanyang or however that's pronounced, one that everybody buys from China, here's a wiring diagram, shows you how to hook it up and where to hook it, plug in things. You wanted to use clear path servos with it, you know, here's the wiring diagram for clear path servos. Gecko G540, you can use that either through the DB25, or you can use it directly from as a driver only, you know, hook it up. Leadshine, you know, here's like a MX4660, you could hook that right up to this and run it.
Now with all of these things online, you're probably wondering, okay, what does this take the place of? This controller board takes the place of a breakout board. It takes the place of a motion controller like a smooth stepper or a UC100. It takes the place of the driver software like Mach 3, because it has its own built-in software. And you know, it'll allow you to do all of these things. Now, Centroid has been out for a while. They're a company that makes conversion kits for larger CNCs, do-it-yourself stuff, and commercial machines. And this is their new entry into the do-it-yourself market again.